Okay. Back, we're going to open boxes 4 through 6. We'll do a recap at the end of this one. Hopefully we'll get a little bit more excitement in these three. What was that Tim Anderson number two, Mike? I remember you asking me about that. I don't remember which one it was. Is that the black auto that was number 35? Got a gold of Cashner? Charlie Morton, red hot? George Brett for the Royals. Die cut. Cespedes for the A's. Randy Johnson for the Expos / Nationals. Yeah, the Schmidt and the Sparkle of Alvarez were probably the two tougher cards we got in the first three. I want to open a pack and see a redemption because the redemption autos are pretty good usually. We got a Robbie Erlund, red hot. Cal Ripken die cut. Jose Fernandez. Martins, Justin Verlander insert. Dom Mattingly. Insert for the Yanks and San Diego Padres before they were great, Tony Gwynn. You know, the Expos, when I break up sets in like the 70s, I sell the Expos team sets usually almost first out of it. Yeah, it's kind of they probably still have some hardcore fans up there that sucks for a franchise. When's your Seattle town going to get basketball back, Freddie? Heard about them getting Supersonics back a few times and it hasn't worked out. Got a Matt Harvey, red hot. Nolan Ryan die cut. Zach Wheeler for the Mets. Upper class insert for Freddie Freeman, Adrian Gonzalez, Marlins, and before they were great, Ken Griffey Jr., who was always great also. Except when he was hurt. Ken Griffey was always great, except when he was hurt. I know they've been so close on the getting the Sacramento Kings. You probably wouldn't feel bad at all about stealing a team from Northern California either. That's like your rival area. Got a Johnny Gomes for the Red Sox. Bryce Harper for the Nationals. Randy Johnson for the Expos. David Price jersey for the Rays. You're going to get all the relics today, Mike. Nice card there, though. Yeah, it'd be tough for us being a Supersonic fan and going through some rough years and then seeing Kevin Durant blow up like that in Oklahoma City. When I was a kid, I remember loving watching the early 80s Supersonics with Fred Brown and Jack Sikma and Johnny Johnson. Fred Brown and couple Fred Brown and Jimmy Johnson both went to Iowa. Chris Medlin Gold for the Braves. Henderson Alvarez for the Marlins. Jason Grilli for the Pirates. Profar for the Rangers. Let's see what we got here. Joey Votto for the Reds. Mike Trout, insert for the Angels. We got a buyback 1970 Topps team card buyback, neat card for the Philadelphia Phillies. So hitting some Phillies cards here. It's a neat card, the team card of the Phillies. Card number 436. Gus Williams, yep. There was others, if I can remember them. Fred Brown was fun to watch. That was back before everybody always shot at NBA three-pointers. Yes, there is bitterness from teams that leave. Go to an older person in Brooklyn and ask them how they like the LA Dodgers. We got Iwakuma, red hot for the Mariners. We got our second, is this our second or third variation? We got a Cabrera. This is our second variation, and we had a Sparkle. So this is our second variation of Josh Reddick for the A's. Oakland was king in the North. So we got a Reddick variation. Chris Davis die cut for the Orioles. Profar for the Rangers. Gary Carter for the Expos. And Phillies, another Phillies buyback of Dick Hall from 1968 Tops. Yeah, I think the Brooklyn Dodgers were a true identity in the town before they left, and it was pretty tough for a lot of them to deal with, but towns were booming out west. What are you gonna do? It's about making money. Got Todd Helton Gold. Got David Holmberg for the Diamondbacks. Paul Goldschmidt, power players. Yu Darvish for the Rangers. Cal Ripken for the Orioles. We got an autograph coming up. So one of the regular autographs. Wade Miley for the Diamondbacks. If it wants to focus. There it is. Wade Miley, good pitcher for the Diamondbacks. That goes to Opus. We had a McCovey insert there too. Just base after that. Let me sleeve and top loader O'Miley. $700,000 at your Seahawks parade. Boy, you do have some bandwagon fans. Oh, good. Well, you just did an autograph for you, Opus. We're on box number four. Let's see. That was the, yep, fourth autograph. Freddie, there is really a lot of towns do have two sets of fans. I mean, some towns have that core, and The bandwagon potential is really varies, but at Iowa, there's some hardcores for college. Dominic Brown for gold. Jonathan Shoop for Red Hot for Red Hot for the Orioles. Aroldis Chapman for the Reds. Cespedes for the A's. Albert Bell for the Indians. And Daryl Strawberry for the Mets. At Iowa football, I mean, we always get 65,000 in the stadium, no matter how bad we are. And I'd like it to say it'd be team dedication, but it's really just a matter of everybody loves the 7, 8 weekends a year where they can go out and tailgate. It really is more about that for a lot of, we've had some bad teams where we average 65,000 fans a year. But people, no matter how bad the team is, don't want to give up that tailgating weekend. Gregor Blanco, gold for the Giants. Brett Gardner, red hot for the Yankees. Felix Hernandez, die cut for the Mariners. Jose Fernandez for the Marlins. Jared Weaver for the Angels. And before they were great, Greg Maddux for the Cubs. That doesn't surprise me. I remember watching Jim Zorn and liking the Seahawks. That was probably before 16 years ago, though. One pack left in box four. This is our manufactured relic. We got a red hot of Ricky Weeks, Yadier Molina for the Cardinals, Cespedes for the A's. We got a rookie class. This is going to go to the Washington Nationals. It's a Randy Johnson in his Expos uniform, rookie class of 1989 for Sergeant Welch. And that's the end of box four. Seahawks got the full color going on. They make some of the best jersey patches for cards too, the Seahawks patches. All kinds of color in there. Freddie, weren't the in this product, there's a Randy Johnson in the Mariners uniform and there's one in the Expos uniform. The one in the die cut, you know, the die cut inserts that I show you, that one's in the Mariners uniform. That's the one we got of Randy Johnson. This one, I don't know if there is an autograph of this one. If there is, it'd be in the Expos. But he split up between the Expos and the Mariners. I think two of them are in the Mariners and one's in the Expo, is what I actually think it is. Ready to get something tough though. This has been the quietest case I've had so far. No doubt about that. JD Martinez for the Astros. Zach Wheeler for the Mets. Got a Jared Weaver for the Angels. I think Griffey's all in the Mariners in this. I'm not 100% sure, but I think he is. We got a jersey card of Bruce Rondon For the Tigers. Pretty sure anything Griffey is in the Mariners, but I'd have to check that group Brooks checklist, but I think it is. Haven't hit any autographs of Griffey in this, though. Not yet. Oh, Seattle. Home base there. We got a red hot of Josh Fields. Die cut of Josh Hamilton. That's the kind of version we got of Randy Johnson, the die cut 1989 that was autographed. We got a Profar for the Rangers. That was a prior case, I should say. Matt Cain for the Giants. Don Mattingly for the Inks. And before they were great, Derek Jeter for the Yankees. Yeah, it was a redemption card. And we actually, Jason didn't actually know for sure who had it at first. I had to find a card for him because he was kind of, he opened it and was unsure if it was Nationals or the Mariners. We've hit three big dollar autographs in this $200 plus, and they've all been redemptions in the seven prior cases. Okay, Soriano Red Hot, Joe Mauer, Power Players, Bryce Harper die cut, Cespedes, Griffey Jr. for the Mariners, Adrian Gonzalez, the Marlins, and Tom Seaver for the Mets. There was a kid at the card show this weekend, Freddie, that was with his father, and they saw one of those old pictures that Sports Illustrated had was the greatest players of the century, and it has A-Rod in that picture in a Seattle uniform. And the kid was like, "When did the kid just would not believe his father that Alex Rodriguez played for Seattle?" And I was sitting there thinking, "I can't believe he's in that picture with those guys. Forget about Seattle." But his numbers up to that point were pretty spectacular, so. It's weird seeing him in that picture, though, with the all-time greats. I think it was a turn of the century Sports Illustrated where they had all of them in one picture. Okay, we got a pink parallel on this one. Something different, at least. We got a Kendrys Morales gold. A Denny Heknavarya. We've got Red Hot. And the pink is San Diego Padres, Tommy Medica for the Padres. Garrett Jones for the Pirates. Power Players, Buster Posey die cut. Yu Darvish insert. And Madison Bumgarner for the Giants. Still haven't hit a rookie reprint, framed rookie reprint. Usually we've had one of those by now. Hopefully we'll get one of those soon. We got Ramirez for gold for Seattle. We got a Mike Karp for the Red Sox. Adrian Gonzalez, Power Players for the Dodgers. Babe Ruth insert for the Yanks. Profar for the Rangers. Strasburg for the Nationals. And before they were great, Mike Mussina for the Orioles. Yeah, you're right. He does have pretty good hitting numbers for the Padres. We got a manufactured relic in this one. Red Hot is of Gerrit Cole. Joey Votto for the Reds insert. And that looks like Bryce Harper for the Nationals. Manufactured Relic Rookie Class of 2012, Bryce Harper. Doesn't want to focus very much, but that's definitely Bryce. So another Nationals, two in a row of those. The other one was an Expo, but Sergeant Welch for that one. Four packs left. All right, Freddy. Brett Obenholzer, gold for the Astros. Boone Logan, red hot for the Yankees. Bryce Harper for the Nationals. Matt Harvey for the Mets. And Daryl Strawberry for the Mets. Three packs left in box five. Alex Gordon for the Royals. Hanley Ramirez, power players for the Dodgers. Andre Dawson for the Cubs. Jose Fernandez for the Marlins. Tom Glavine for the Braves. And we got a buyback Rick Baldwin, 77 taps for the Mets. Freddie, I got one little girl, and she's kind of adopted my OCD thing of wanting to sort things and stuff, so I think I have a future employee on the hand. She's 8 years old, and she's starting to sort. Oh, wow, cool. We got a redemption. Good luck, everybody. There's a redemption peeking out there. I'm not sure if it's a big dollar card, but my redemptions in the past have been strong out of this, so good luck, everybody. Hopefully it's a big one. We haven't gotten the autograph out of this box, so hoping for the best here. I'd love to see it be one of the Strat autographs. That'd be awesome. We got a gold of Wainwright, Zimmerman, and Kershaw. That's okay, Mo. I stumble over my keyboard plenty. Justin Smoke for the Mariners. Hoping it's a Strat. I really, really do hope it's one of those. Cespedes insert for the A's. Brian McCann for the Braves. And Willie McCovey's going to be the blocker here. So McCovey's going to see what we have. Put it up real clear so everybody can see it. Topps Online Redemption Card. Congratulations. You are due to receive Trajectory Autograph. Now, that's one of the regular autographs. So, I'm not sure what that means. We'll see. Of Luis Aparicio. Well, Not as big as some of the other ones, but that's still a solid autograph. He's definitely one of the short prints. It's probably White Sox, but I'll double check it. I don't know if Aparicio played for anybody else besides the White Sox. I was hoping for Estrada. Hoping. I'll check, or if one of you guys see that's probably the White Sox. But Aparicio played some for some other teams. Checklist will tell us though. I was hoping for, say, Strata, because those are all monstrous autographs. Got me some excitement at least. Is it the White Sox? Sure, I'm sure that's a short print autograph. Fairly tough to get. That's definitely worth the White Sox purchase there, TNP. You think Aparicio is a Mariner? I don't think he might have played 2 years where the Mariners existed. Aparicio, I think, played till 74. I don't know, somewhere in there. The Mariners started in 71. Brad Peacock for the Astros. Joaquin Benoit for the Tigers. Jose Fernandez for the Marlins. Kimbrel for the Braves. And Mike Trout for the Angels. We got is this 58? I think this is 58. We got a 50s buyback of Jerry Walker for the Baltimore Orioles. And commons after that. My heart's still racing for the redemption. Really wanted to see it see Strata. That's the end of box five. It's a nice White Sox card, though. Has anybody checked to see if there's any Aparicios on there, how tough he is? Can't be too often. Yeah, there's one active. He's not big dollar, but he's tough to get. It looks like a $25 auto. Be a nice collectible, though. Hall of Fame autograph. Jeremy Hellick's in upper class. He's hurt again, I think, too, isn't he? He's been hurt so many times. Yeah, that'd be depressing to get a redemption and get Jeremy Hellickson with some of the redemptions that I've had and seen. You want that second line to say Strata. Even though this trajectory autographs do have some real good short prints, I mean, Koufax and Aaron are in that set. All right, this is box six. Good luck, everybody. Let's have a last one with a few tough cards in it to end up. Start off with a red hot of Starling Marte. We got a Stanton Power Players. Roberto Clemente die cut for the Pirates. Mike Trout for the Angels. Dustin Pedroia, the Red Sox. And Albert Pujols for the Cardinals. Oh wow, Richard Petty booklet. What's something like that go for, Opus? I would think that'd be pretty big dollars. That was in Five Star Racing. I've seen a lot of people break on those Five Star Racing on breakers. All right, we got a Ricky Weeks red hot. Wow, well, congratulations. That's a big hit. Manny Ramirez Oriole. Tulowitzki For the Rockies, we got the relic card of Elvis Andres for the Rangers. And base after that. Is that something you keep, or are you going to turn that around and make a little money on? I would think there'd be fans out there for something like that. Got about 10 packs left. Got a variation in this pack. First card is Cespedes for the A's. We got a variation of the Tampa Bay Rays. Nice one of Evan Longoria. Now we'll do the recap after this. I might need a second to sleeve some stuff up, but we got St. Louis Cardinals, power players of Molina, Kershaw die cut of the Dodgers, Shelby Miller insert for the Cardinals, Bo Jackson for the Royals, and Derek Jeter for the Yankees. Oh, cool. You know, we have a big dollar auto, an 8-player football auto that's the same way. We didn't randomize it. We're going to try to sell and split it up. Cigari in the room has half of it now, and Mike has an eighth, I believe, and Freddie has still a fourth. And we're doing the same thing. We didn't, hopefully, we, I know Cigari actually was thinking about trying to get it himself at some point, so probably after the second week we'll figure it out if Cigari wants to keep trying buying or if we'll run it as an auction where they can all bid on it. But will be a nice card, but that's good. You guys could both get a piece of it that way. We got a gold insert coming up. We got Ryan Cook of the A's and a black insert. Got some parallels in this pack. Danny Farquhar, red hot for the Mariners. We got a Twins, Josmil Pinto, black parallel. Zach Wheeler for the Mets. Jay Bruce for the Reds. Johnny Bench for the Reds. And right after that's another Johnny Bench. Mays will like this. Mays gets a lot of the red things, and it's a parallel of Johnny Bench. Oops. You know, it doesn't want to. Yeah, I'll skip showing you the number and just say it. It's 89 of 99 for the bench. So a nice parallel there for Mays. We got a gold of Howie Kendrick. Luis Valbuena for the Cubbies. Red hot. Yeah, Freddie, if you talk to Cigar, he's in the room, but he may not be paying attention. I'm not sure. But if you talk to him, I'm sure he'll offer you something. He's been working on buying it up. I know Mike was interested in keeping it too, but I know Cigari has half of it right now. We got Lee Smith die cut for the Cardinals. Whatever you guys, it's you guys' card, so I'm just kind of letting you guys work it out. We got a Puig insert for the Dodgers, David Wright for the Mets, and DiMaggio for the Yanks. The other person with the eighth of it is Bassin, who comes in a lot of the football breaks and is about willing to do anything you guys do on it. Five packs left. All right, we got a gold of Victor Martinez for the Tigers, Todd Helton, the Rockies, Shelby Miller for the Cardinals, Bryce Harper for the Nationals, and here's an auto. Matt Adams for the Cardinals. It's a guy that might have a really good year for the Cardinals. And the Cardinals was Seabergs. Sleep those last couple cards real quick. Oh, you know, I think I sent. Oh, we did get our rookie reprint there finally. Looks like a bronze one. I think I sent out one email, Freddie, where I mentioned it in the second part, but I'm not sure. But he's pretty patient guy, Cigari is. So I think he was willing to wait it out. But oh yeah, there he is. Yeah, see, I mean, I know he wanted it. He's just a patient guy that is willing to wait it out. What else you watching, Cigari? I'm kind of curious what else you're breaking. We got DeRosa Gold for the Blue Jays. We got a Jeremy Hellickson for the Rays. We got an Andrew McCutcheon die cut for the Pirates. We're almost to the reprint, so we'll show that in a second. Profar for the Rangers. Good luck, everybody. This is one of the bronze ones. So it should be the number to 199. Oh, I know who that is. That's a neat one. What a cool card. This is what I like when Topps does this kind of stuff. Of course, I'm a sucker for vintage baseball. Number 127 of 199. It's a framed rookie reprint of Sandy Koufax from his 55 Topps card. I've had exactly one of these in my lifetime. There's the back. Same set as Clemente's rookie. So cool card. I don't know what it goes for on eBay, but that's a neat card. To Sergeant Welch. Set that there for the recap. Okay. Oh, you got that one in silver? That's a neat card. I really do like that card. I saw an awesome Brooklyn Dodgers autograph cut thing this weekend in Chicago with Jackie Robinson, a bunch of things. That was a pretty neat card. Pretty neat framed item, I should say. We got our manufactured relic in this pack. Last box having a few more fun cards. Jared Cozart for the Astros Red Hot. Freddie Freeman for the Braves. And the relic, Ty Cobb for the Detroit Tigers. And Seabergs. two packs left. If any of you leave before the recap, let me just say I appreciate you joining the break. We have Heritage Baseball on Thursday, and I have several teams left in that, and I do expect to sell that out. I'd be pretty surprised if I don't. So if you want a team, you may want to email early on that one. Know all the short prints better and stuff now, and that'll go a little quicker. Last time was a really long break, but it'll go a little quicker this time. And then we have a lot of football on Friday. We're doing National Treasures and Chrome, and I'm sending out those prices tonight in that. So I will have some museum baseball, two full master cases. We got Pedro Alvarez gold, Josh Beckett for the Dodgers red hot, Zach Wheeler for the Mets, Freddie Lynn for the Red Sox, Joe Mauer for the Twins, and we got an Expos buyback, Wayne Twitchell. What the heck? Twitchell. I don't remember that name. Wayne Twitchell for the Expos. I'll probably have some boxes offered off, maybe open Friday night if anybody's interested, or Saturday night. And I'll probably do a group break either Sunday or Tuesday of next week, maybe a week from today. It's not 100% yet, but I am doing football on Friday night. Here's the last pack. Thanks, everybody, for joining the break. We got Rafael Betancourt, Red Hot, Chris Perez, Power Players, Joey Votto, die cut for the Reds, Will Myers for the Rays, Ernie Banks for the Cubs, got a 59 buyback. God, this thing's in great shape, even though it's way off center. Got it. If it was center good, I've actually heard of him too. Mudcat Grant for the Indians. And we got Pedro Martinez for the Dodgers. And the before they were great. And that's the end of the six boxes. Might take me a minute here, but I'm going to do the recap. Working alone today, so I got to organize these a little bit myself. I'll recap what we got out of these six boxes. And then hopefully I'll see some of you Tuesday night. Autos. A little tough for working this alone. Should be ready in a second, though, for those of you sticking around. Fortunately, we didn't get as many tougher cards this case. I might be a little spoiled. I've had some really good cases out of this Topps one. Okay, here's the two missing cards. Okay, welcome. This is the recap for the 2014 Topps 1 break number 8, case break number 8. Go over the cards that we hit real quick. We hit six of the manufactured relics. They were Clayton Kershaw, Cal Ripken, Yogi Berra? Randy Johnson? Bryce Harper? And Ty Cobb. We had six of the regular relics. Hopefully I got all six in this recap. I did. Good. Elvis Andrus for the Rangers. Bruce Rondon for the Tigers. These are both jerseys. We did it one bat. Mark Teixeira for the Yanks. We had a one vintage one. Mike Schmidt from the Phillies with a little red pinstripe. Nice looking card. David Price. And Pedro Alvarez for the Pirates. We did hit a really tough Pedro Alvarez. Also, we hit one of the sparkles of him. And variations. I have Longoria here. We also hit Miguel Cabrera. I might have mixed it up with my inserts. And we hit, I think it was just those two and the sparkle of Alvarez. We, let's see. We did hit one rookie reprint, which was Sandy Koufax from the 55 Tops, numbered to 199. We hit one of the gold before they were greats, Johnny Bench, numbered to 99. And we hit six autographs. We hit Matt Adams for the Cardinals. Oops. Chris Archer for the Rays. Wade Miley for Arizona. Jake Mirschnick for the Marlins. Andrew Lambeau for the Pirates was in the first box. And we hit one of the short print ones, redemption card, Luis Aparicio, which I'm pretty sure is the White Sox, but I will double check it. And that is it. Thanks for everybody. This is the end of the YouTube cast. And look for Heritage Baseball on Thursday. And we'll be doing some football breaks on Friday also. If you have any questions, feel free to email me via eBay or my regular email.